हेलो चिल्ड्रन, माई सेल्फ ईश्वर चंद गलीचवाल वेलकम्स ऑल ऑफ यू। टुडे वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग आवर चैप्टर 11th मेंसुरेशन। नाउ टुडे वी लर्न लेटरल सरफेस एरिया, ओके, द साइड वॉल्स दैट इज द फेसेज excluding the top and bottom make the lateral surface area of the cuboid, okay? So now we understand clearly how the lateral surface area looks like. This is the lateral surface area and base and roof, that is total surface area. If we remove the base and roof of a room, we get the lateral surface area, that is the walls only, okay, front and back wall, and these are the side walls. So this way we can express the lateral surface area, and this is the base, that is bottom, and this is the roof. When we include both of these, we get the total surface area of a cuboid. So now this is a lateral surface area of cuboid. So we found the formula for this. So the total area of all the four walls is the lateral surface area of room. Okay. So lateral surface area of cuboid is twice H into L plus B into H. This is H and this is L. So H into L and this is H into L. So twice HL and this is B into H and this is also B into H. Okay. So this way we can found. By taking H common, we get twice H into L plus B. This is the lateral surface area of cuboid. Okay. So, total surface area of cuboid equals lateral surface area plus base and roof. And the base and roof are twice area of base, because roof is also equal to the base. So, twice area of base, if we adding this in the lateral surface area, we get the total surface area. Okay. So this is very clear how is the lateral surface area and total surface area. So we represent the total surface area of cuboid 2H L plus B. This is lateral surface area plus twice LB. This is the twice area of the base, and this way we get the total surface area. Okay. If we include this in that, so we again get the total surface area. Now we learn about cube. All the faces of a cube are square in shape. This makes length, height and width of a cube equal. Okay. So now we express the surface, total surface area of a cube. This is the cube, and every edge of a cube is A, because length, height and width of a cube are equal, and let they are A. When we express on the paper this cube, this becomes this and this, the front and back area, and this and this the side area, and this is top and bottom area. So all of this include total surface area of a cube. Okay. Total surface area of cube. If we put the value of L, B and H are A, then we get twice A into A plus A into A plus A into A. Because we know the area of total surface area of cuboid twice L in into B into B into H into L. So put everywhere, we put A because L equals B equals H. So on the place of all that we put A. So we get A into A is the area of a single face. So one type of faces are three times. This is the front face, this is the side face, this is the top face. Okay. And by making twice, we get the total six face. Now calculate this area. A square plus A square plus A square. Twice. 2 into 3A square, that is 6A square. So total surface area of cube is 6A square. Okay. Now, lateral surface area. Lateral surface area means only the four walls and all walls are square. So 4A square is the lateral surface area. Now we learn cylinders. Most of the cylinder we observe are right circular cylinders. For example, 18 round pillars, tube lights, water pipes, etc. Okay. Now we learn the cylinder. This is the cylinder. This is the curved part and this is the top and bottom of the cylinder. When we express this in paper, it looks like this. And when we cut this and spread it, it become this type. And this are the top and bottom. So the area of top, pi r square, because this is circle. Area of bottom, this is also pi r square, because this is circle. And this is the circumference of this circle. When we stretch it, this is the straight. So 2 pi r is the circumference. And this is the h. This is h and this is 2 pi r. So 2 pi r into h is 2 pi r h. This is the curved surface area. So by adding the 3, we get the total surface area. So lateral surface area of cylinder is this curved part. This is the lateral surface area. That is 2 pi r h. And the total surface area of cylinder is 2 pi r square. Pi r square plus pi r square, 2 pi r square. And this 2 pi r h also. By taking 2 pi r h common, we get 2 pi r into r plus h. So this is the total surface area of cylinder. Okay. So remember this and using this. Now we learn some example. Example first. An aquarium is in the form of a cuboid whose external measures are 80 cm into 30 cm into 40 cm. Okay. The base, side face and back face are to be covered with a colored paper. Find the area of paper needed. Okay. So we have to calculate the area of these faces and by adding we get this required paper. Here we are given length of the aquarium L is 80 cm. Width of the aquarium B is 30 cm. Height of the aquarium H 40 cm. So area of base, length into width 80 into 30. 2400 cm square. Now area of the side face B into H 13 to 40, that is 1200 cm square. Area of the back face L into H, that is 18 to 40, 3200 cm square. Okay, so required area is area of the base, area of the back face and twice area of the side face, because there are two sides. Okay, and one back face and one base. So there are total four faces. So area of the base, this 2400 cm. Area of the back face, 3200. And area of side face is 1200. And now we multiply by 2. Okay, so this way we get the required area. So 2400 plus 3200 plus 2400. By solving this, we get this. Now by adding, we get the 8000 centimeter square. So, hence the area of colored paper required is 8000 centimeter square. Okay, now we learn one more example. Find the height of a cylinder whose radius is 7 centimeter and the total surface area is 968 centimeter. Okay, so let height of cylinder is h and radius is r. Here we provide the radius 7 centimeter, so put 7 centimeter here. Now we know total surface area is 2 pi r h plus r. Okay, this is the total surface area of cylinder. Now we put the value. Value of radius is 7 here and here. H we don't know. We have to require H to found. And 968 is the total surface area already given to us. So by putting here the values and equalize it to 968, we solve. 2 pi value 22 by 7, R 7, H we don't know. And R 7. Now this 7 is cancelled by this 7. So 22 into 2, 44. 44 multiplying by 7 and H, and by separate the variables, we get this H equal to 968 minus 22 into 2, 44 into this 7, and by dividing 44, we get the H 15 centimeter. Okay. Hence, the height of the cylinder is 15 centimeter. So, this way you can solve the problem. Now, we take more example. In a building, there are 24 cylindrical pillars. The radius of each pillar is 28 centimeter. Okay. And height is 4 meter. Find the total cost of painting the curved surface area of all the pillars at the rate of rupees 8 per meter square. Okay. So, what we have to given? Radius of each pillar is 28 centimeter. So, radius of cylindrical pillar R is 28 centimeter. We convert this into meter. By dividing 100, we get 0.28 meter. Height H is provided 4 meter. So, H equal to 4. Curved surface area of cylinder, we know 2 pi r h. Okay. Curved surface area of a pillar is this 2 pi r h. Because the pillars are cylindrical, so this is the area. 2 pi is the 22 by 7. R is the 0.28. And H is the 4. Remove this decimal by dividing 100. Now, this is 28. So, cancel by 7 4 times. So 4 for just 16, and this is 22 into 2, 44. By multiplying this, we get 704 upon 100, and by divide this 100, we get 7.04 meter square. This is the curved surface area of a single pillar. Now, in the question, we have provided 24 cylindrical pillars. So to get the area, we have to multiply by 24. Curved surface area of 24 such pillars is, by multiplying 24, we get 168.96 meter square. Now we have to provide cost of painting an area of 1 meter square. This is given to us, rate, rupees 8 per meter square. That is, cost of an area of 1 meter square, painting rate is rupees 8. Therefore, cost of painting 168.96 meter square is, by multiplying 8, we get this. So, rupees 1351.68 is the cost. So, this way we can solve the problem. So, solve the question of exercise. Okay. This is your homework. If you have any problem, then consult me on my personal WhatsApp, okay? Have a nice day. Thanks.